Hi everyone, I am Satya Sekar, a developer evangelist with Salesforce. In this quick tech, I'll show you how to configure and use the ScratchOG from the VS Code. ScratchOGs are temporary development environments that you can spawn on demand. It is fully configurable that allows you to emulate different Salesforce editions with various features and preferences. The only requirement is you need to enable the DevHub from the settings in your production or developer edition org. Once you enable the DevHub, you can track all your ScratchOGs from this DevHub org. From the app launcher, you can check which ScratchOGs are active and you can also check the ScratchOG related information. You can find more information about the ScratchOGs from the Salesforce DX guide in the developer documentation at developer.salesforce.com site. For instance, you can note from here that ScratchOGs can hold up to 200 MB of data and 50 MB of files. You can create 6 ScratchOGs each day and can have up to 3 active ScratchOGs in the developer edition. Similarly, you can create 80 daily and 40 active ScratchOGs in the enterprise edition. And this limit is 200 daily and 100 active ScratchOGs for unlimited and performance editions. Let's start by creating a Salesforce development project. One thing to be done before we create the ScratchOG is to authorize the DevHub org. We can either use the command palette or the terminal. Let's do that from the terminal. Here, you can type the command sfdx force auth web login, give an alias, say DevHub, and set it as the default org. Enter your credentials at the login page. Once authorized, you can close the tab and go back to VS Code. Here, you can see that you have successfully authorized the DevHub org. Once you create the Salesforce development project, we can define the ScratchOG settings and configurations even before we create the ScratchOGs. You can find the configuration files in the config directory. You can create the ScratchOG with the default configurations, or you can create one or more definition files to emulate different shapes with different configurations. And later, you can use the config file to create the ScratchOG. Okay, let's now see few important options that can be considered. I can keep track of the ScratchOGs by defining a proper org name. I can set the edition. This is the only mandatory option. I can set my email here so that any notifications related to ScratchOGs will be sent to this email rather than the email that is set in the DevHub. You can also add a description here to define the purpose of your ScratchOG so that it will be easy for you to identify the ScratchOG later. It's also important to note that the ScratchOGs are created without data by default. But if you want to add the data similar to the developer edition, you can do that by setting hasSampleDataValue to true. You can enable the features that you want in your ScratchOG. For example, if you examine this definition file from the developer documentation, the communities cloud, service cloud, and chatbot features are enabled. You can define the org preferences like session timing, case email, etc. using the settings option. You can create orgs with different shapes using a combination of features and settings. Okay, let us now save the configuration and create the ScratchOG. Let's open the command palette and type create scratch and choose sfdx create a default ScratchOG. Next, we can enter the ScratchOG definition file name or we can choose the default suggestion. We can enter an alias now or accept the default alias, which is our project name. Let's give a name here. ScratchOGs are created with long usernames, so alias can be very handy for the username in the CLI commands. Next, it will prompt you for how long you'd like the ScratchOGs to exist. Maximum is 30 days and default is 7. Let's stick to default and press enter. Now, let's open the Scratchog. You can use the command palette or click this little icon at the bottom to do the wonder. See how easy it was to log in without remembering the password. Let's open the sales app and open an account record. Here you can see some data because we have marked has sample data to true in our Scratchog definition. Let's now see how we can work with the code. We'll write some code, push it to the Scratchog, make some admin tasks or automations in the Scratchog, and we'll pull the changes from there. Okay, let's create a Lightning web component. Let's call it greeting. Add some code to it. We'll now push the changes to the org. You can either use the command palette or Salesforce CLI. Let's use the command palette and push the changes. While we push the changes, let's see in the output panel. You can also notice that it generates equivalent Salesforce CLI command and its execution. We'll now create an application and add our Hello component to it. Let's click on New Lightning App. Let's call it, say, Sample App. We'll add the home page. To keep the thing simple, we'll add our component to this home page. Choose a user profile to give the access. Finish it to create the app. Let's open the Sample App. And edit the home page. Drag and drop the greeting component, activate the page, and save it. Let's click on back. You can see that the component is added. We can now pull the changes from the org. Let's go back to the VS Code. In the command palette, enter pull and choose SFDX pull source from default Scratchog. You can see the changes pulled in the Salesforce CLI output. If there are any conflicts and you still want to pull the changes, you can choose SFDX pull source from default Scratchog and override the conflicts. Ideally, we can use the VS Code to make the changes in the source and push the changes to the Scratchog. You can use the Scratchog for any admin or automation related changes and pull those changes back. Once the code is final, you can also check in the code into the Git repository. You can also work with the Scratchog from the integrated terminal of the VS Code using SFDX force commands. When you run the command from the command palette, the equivalent CLI commands are executed, which we saw in the Salesforce CLI output. If you are done with the Scratchog before expiry time, you can mark it for deletion using the CLI command. Let's do that. We can use force or delete to delete our My Demo Scratchog. In this video, we covered what is Scratchog. We saw the Scratchog definition file, created a Scratchog, pushed the changes to the Scratchog, and viewed the changes. We also pulled the changes from the Scratchog and finally deleted the Scratchog. Thanks for watching. If you learned something, be sure to like this video. If you want to get more content like this pushed directly to you, click subscribe and that bell to get notifications.